Go ahead, sir.
Everybody smile, the brush is coming in.
Oh,
all right. Just put the smile over here.
I think I'll get this picture that way. This
doesn't
sound good. They always cut me off right here.
That's a dirty trick, isn't it?
I'm going to get so close to my car, I can't separate.
One of those cardinal rules in politics is always get your hand all the way around so they know they can cut it off.
That's right.
Oh, I
but it's all machine votes. It's going to be hard to see, especially if you governor on our side.
Mr. President, is it now time to impose the War Powers Act?
The only statement I have to make today is that things seem to be quieting down in the Gulf. We hope it continues that way, and the main purpose of this meeting today is to talk about the trade bill.
Do you have any news about the missing helicopter?
Well, I have to answer that in the sense that there are 9 ships right now trying to find the answer to that.
Well, Iran says it shot the helicopter down in a state of all-out war now exists in the Gulf.
Well, ask them questions whether they mean it or not.
Did we underestimate Iran's response?
Mr. President, is the action over as far as the United States is concerned, or do we plan further action against Iran?
I just told you that it seems to be quieting down. We hope it continues that way.
Lights, please. Thank you.
That's right, please. Thank you.
Sunday night, after consulting with the bipartisan leadership of the House and Senate, you know, I ordered a measured response we thought proportionate to Iran's recent resumption of mine laying in international waters and its mine attack on the Samuel B. Roberts. The government of Iran has been repeatedly warned about the consequences of such hostile acts, and our actions were designed and intended to deter Iran's unlawful use of force against the United States and Iran's numerous violations of the rights of non-belligerents. We've repeatedly told them that we don't desire military confrontation but that the government of Iran should understand that we will protect our ships and interests against unprovoked attacks. And we seek an end to tension in the whole region there, and an end to that Iran-Iraq war, which has been such a brutal conflict and cost so many. And I'm going to ask Frank Carlucci and Admiral Crow to bring us up to date on events in the Gulf.
Thank you, Mr. President. Let me ask you what the President provided. He set the broad goals. His instructions were clear and unambiguous, firm from the outset, and he allowed the military to carry out its responsibility within those goals. Secondly, the policy coordination process worked effectively, the interagency process. Third was the leadership demonstrated by Admiral Kraut and the Joint Chiefs. Fourth,
great to see you, sir. What a day. My wife, Judy.
How are you? Good to see you.
This is our son, Sean.
Why don't you get in the middle here? Yeah. You don't come in there. I mean, you do come in there. I don't have a picture today.
Thank you, sir.
You were so nice to do this. You know, we got a bunch of thugs and ruffians out there now. They're just waiting. Some of them have no
linemen myself.
Well, all the handbacks are telling the linemen what to do.
That's why I played the game.
Listen, the Notre Dame contingent is already trying to take over. They're organizing out there and trying to take over.
Well, I think I better start getting
them. So let's get them in. Okay, great. Thank you.
Okay,
Jay.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Nice to be here. It's a pleasure. All right. Good luck to you. Thank you. Thank you.
Larry Kelly. Congratulations to you, sir. Good to see you.
President Angelo Bertelli.
Nice to see you. I didn't see you as well.
President Les Harbin, United States. Nice to see you. Thank you for having us.
Leon Harkness.
Hello.
Nice to see you.
President Dick Kazmaier, good to see you again here as well. Can you tell him the story?
The oldest, Jay Bernwanger, and the newest, Billy Sims. And a lot of other right wingers here. And Mr. President, I would just like to present you this football. Now, you're accustomed of a different kind of nuclear football, but I want you to know that this one is a real pigskin and signed by all this group, and we're just so very proud to be here with you.
Listen, I'm very proud to have this one for the Gipper. I'm very excited to have this and proud to have all of you here. And sports was not only in my playing days, but then later on when I was sports announcer, a great part of my life. People wonder what happens to football players after they quit playing 2 years later.
They just get better and better every year.
Well, I'm very proud to have this.
Well, we hope that you'll find a place for that. Not confused with the other one.
I have a hunch that that's true. The presidential is about to be good. Well, let me
So here, do some little, just souvenirs here. For these are not Ivan trophies. Key rings with the seal.
Thank you, Mr. President. That's a real treat. Thank you, sir.
I can get them out of here. Somebody suggested to me, tempted me to suggest to me that I'm going to visit it out of my life again. I played in the line.
Thank you.
That is another lineman.
I don't know where you heard me tell this story.
Thank you, sir.
Out at the ranch. I was still governor of California. We just bought this new ranch. Oh, several staff members had come up to join me in working on the house and straightening out.
Yes.
And we have two more people over here who, and you two, should come in. Tim for you. Key ring for you. But I'm gonna finish this story now. All help out. So one of the young fellows there, staff, he and I jumped in the jeep and we went down to pick up some kind of creek rocks that we were kind of using, a little decorating out there on the lawn. And we didn't find any, and we were coming back, and all of a sudden he said, snake. And I stopped the jeep, and I said, where? And he says, over here on the bank. Well, I started getting out, and I said, look, I don't go around killing things, but this is a rattlesnake, I'm going to kill it, and so forth. So I went around the front of the jeep, and there it was on the bank, and it was trying to get away. It was about a 4-foot rattler. And I started, my favorite way of getting rid of them is to find a stone about so big and then lean over and dunk it on their head. And that usually does it. You don't have to get too close to them. And I couldn't find anyone. As I was starting around the jeep, when I said that thing about the rattler, he was coming down and he started backing up out of the jeep. I killed it. I knew it was. But finally, I looked, just desperately, was almost into the rocks to get away. I picked up off the road a little stone that was about the size of a lime, and I let go, and I hit it right on the head. Splat. That was it. I got in the jeep, didn't say anything, he didn't say anything. We drove home, or down to the house. I went inside, I heard him outside with the others, and I heard him say, I was in there with Nancy, and I heard him say, and then he picked up this stone, and he threw that stone, and he hit that stone right on the head. And I said to Nancy, and he will never see me throw a stone.
That is a good one.
Mr. President was a very prolific passer at Notre Dame when he was handed the football a few weeks ago, and he hit Timmy Brown right on the button.
Really? Yes, I didn't know. Moose Krause handed me the football. I thought it was doing what you were doing. But I took the ball, and then he said, no, he said, pointed out there, that big crowd in there, and he said, the team was over there, all the fellas in the team were over there someplace, and, well, one fella stood up and put up his arm, and I could see that above the head of everything. It was kind of dark out there. And I let fly. And it was their Heisman Trophy. And dead center.
Did he make the catch?
He made it. I don't think I'll ever let them see me throw a pass again.
Well, you're working your way through the sports with stones and footballs, and you've still got shot puts and baseballs, so you've still got a few good shots left in you. A few good tosses.
Well, listen, it's just great to see you, and I know I'm good to see you all again, and I shouldn't take up your time. I shouldn't go on here because you're going to have to listen to me for a little while tonight.
Thank you, Mr. President. We really appreciate it. Great honor.
We need him here.
We're all here to help.
We hope to help.
This is a whale of a team. Whale of a
yes,
team.
Yes. Really, I don't think any other candidate will be able to show anything like this.
Well, thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you.
All right.
Thank you, Mr. President. Nice to see you.
You're the first Heisman Trophy.
That's right. Still around.
You're doing tremendous job.
I was back in the sports and music era.
Yes, very much. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Those were great days.
Yes, they were. Why don't you guys stay? Days we got
yeah, yes, they are. Yeah, they get better. Yeah.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. See you.
Thank you, Mr. President. Thank you, Mr. President.
Enjoyed being here with the President.
Thanks a lot for having us, sir.
Well, please. So kind of slippery. Is this really the kind they play with? Looks at it. I'd want some rosin on my hand for this. Hop right up.
Where's Ray?